नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल लर्न स्टैंडर्ड 7th सोशल साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 1, टू बिग स्टेट। देर इज ए 3 पार्ट एंड फर्स्ट पार्ट वी लर्न अबाउट कनौज, हाउ किंग हर्षवर्धन बिकम द किंग, एंड हर्षवर्धन रेन एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, इम्प्रिंट्स लेफ्ट बाय हर्षवर्धन एंड नालंदा यूनिवर्सिटी। इन सेकंड सेशन वी लर्न लाइफ ऑफ द पीपल, व्हाट इज द लाइफ ऑफ पीपल एट द किंग हर्षवर्धन टाइम, व्हाट रोट ह्यूएन सांग इन हिज बुक अबाउट हर्षवर्धन, एंड पुलकेशी टू वातापी, सेकंड स्टेट वातापी, एंड हाउ पुलकेशी टू बिकम ए किंग, बिकॉज पुलकेशी टू वॉज द किंग ऑफ चालुक्य डायनेस्टी ऑफ साउथ इंडिया। फर्स्ट किंग पुलकेशी वन वॉज किंग, देन हिज सन कृतिवर्मा असेंड द थ्रोन, एंड देन पुलकेशी टू बिकम द किंग फॉर 30 ईयर्स। नाउ इन थर्ड सेशन वी विल लर्न हाउ पुलकेशी टू बिकम अ ब्रेव एंड वॉट बैटल फील्ड ही फोट विथ अदर्स एंड हर्षवर्धन ऑल्सो, एंड वॉट ह्यूएन सांग रोट इन हिज डायरी अबाउट पुलकेशी टू एंड वेन पुलकेशी टू डाइड। लेट्स स्टार्ट द लेसन। पुलकेशी टू 610-642 CE। पुलकेशी वॉज ए वैलियंट किंग who won many battles. His first victory was over Lath. It is located in South Gujarat, followed by his win over Gujarat. It is Gurjar is located in North Gujarat. He gained control over the Vengi region that lay between the rivers Krishna and Godavari, and also acquired Andhra Pradesh. He transformed the capital Vatapi into a city magnificent and splendor. Here the meaning of valiant means to be very courageous and very brave person. Magnificent and splendor means very make brilliance and grand. In short, Pulkesi too was a very valiant and brave person. He had got victories in many battles. He had won Lath region, it is in South Gujarat, and also Gurjar region, it is in North Gujarat. He also control over Vengi region, it is located river between Krishna and Godavari, and also ruled over Andhra Pradesh too. He transferred his capital, he was the king of capital of Vatapi, and also he transferred his capital in a very brilliant and grand. The armies of Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II fought a great battle near river Narmada, in which the former was defeated. The armies of Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II, there is a battlefield, and in the battlefield, King Harshvardhan was defeated and Pulkesi II was become winner. This halted Harsh expansion towards South India, and so the empire of Kanauj could not extend beyond Narmada. Now King Harshvardhan also defeated in the battlefield in Narmada, so he can't make very big his state, and he want to extend his Kanauj, but because of he defeated, so he can't make it very big beyond to Narmada. Here also we have question, why was there a war between Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II? Harsh and Pulkesi II were undoubtedly valiant, but they fought because Harsh wanted his expand his kingdom up to from North India to South India, while Pulkesi II also wanted to extend his boundary of his empire to North India. Thus, both of them were ambitious to extend their empires. The armies of both them clashed at the Narmada, and there was a war between King Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II, and Pulkesi II also defeated King Harshvardhan. The empire of Harsh thus could not extend beyond of Narmada. Now, Pulkesi II was not only a great warrior, but also a lover of arts. The cave of Vatapi and Dharapuri were built during his reign. The famous cave murals of Ajanta, here also picture given, were also painted at that time. In his travel, Yuan Shang visited the court of Pulkesi II and has given a vivid account of its grandeur. The king of Chalukya dynasty were followers of Hinduism. During this time, Buddhism went into decline, while the Digambar Jain sect gained popularity. In this paragraph, we understand Pulkesi II was a lover of arts. During his period, the cave of Patapi and Dharapuri were constructed. The certain worldwide known cave mural Ajanta were also painted on those time. Yuan Shang also traveling across India and had reached court to Pulkesi II. He had admired Pulkesi II's wealth a lot. The king of Chalukya dynasty followed Hindu religion, and during his time, Buddhism were to the decline. Here the meaning of decline is sloping down, go down. So during his time, Buddhism went to down, and while the Digambar Jain sect again popularity. Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II were contemporary rulers. Contemporary means both are same rulers. King Harshvardhan was the king of North India and Pulkesi II was the king of South India. However, Harsh fought fewer battles as compared to Pulkesi, who continued waging wars. He finally met his end in 642 CE in a conflict with the Pallav king of Kanchipuram. King Harshvardhan died 5 years after him. In short, Harshvardhan and Pulkesi II was contemporary kings. Harshvardhan wound up making wars after a few wars, while the Pulkesi II continued his waging wars, and as a result, in 642 CE, King Pulkesi II was defeated and died with the King Pallav of Kanchipuram, while the King Harshvardhan died in 5 years after him. In short, Harshvardhan died in 647 CE. So here is one question: who was better king, King Harshvardhan or Pulkesi II? We can find the answer. In Emperor, Harshvardhan was better king than Pulkesi II because he was very valiant, religion loving, and we also read in his time what happened and what is the life of the people. King Harshvardhan also built many rest houses, wells, step wells, lakes, mud viharas for people, and also he was the loving of literature. The great Sanskrit poet and writer Banbhat adored his court. So he is also very, and he himself, King Harsh himself also was a writer and wrote 3 plays, Nagananda, Ratnavali and Priyadarshika. So we can say he was the lover of literature. In his time, King Harsh also extended all possible assistance to Acharya Silbhadra and make Nalanda University famous university. And his life The people was very happy. Also, Chinese traveler Yuan Zhang wrote in his book Villages about, and it was also huge entrance and gateway, and people was very safe. In his time, the life of people was very simple. Here, occupation was husbandry, farming and husbandry occupations, and gold and silver coins were commercial transaction. For this, India increased her prosperity. Also, King Harsh also built 100 mutts for Buddhism, and people lived very pious, peaceful life, and rulers, he is a very good ruler. Also, he had a deep understanding and sense of administration. He appointed different ministers and secretaries, run out administration in his state. While comparison to Pulkesi II, he won many battles, and he was a very valiant person. But had been famous valiant king, but had not carried out very famous work and state administration or public welfare like Harsh. So in comparison to King Harsh and Pulkesi II, Harsh king was very better. Thank you for joining us.